Hello, my dear children. I hope you all are well and safe at home. A warm welcome to all the students of class 2 to today's English grammar class. The topic of today's session is masculine and feminine nouns. In today's session, myself Swati Malik is there with you. Let's begin our today's session. As you all might not be having English grammar book, let me give you a short introduction to your English grammar book. Your book name is Grammatics. Today, we will study Chapter 7, Masculine and Feminine Noun. Let's begin our topic with the types of gender. There are basically four types of gender: masculine gender, feminine gender, neuter gender, and common gender. Masculine gender includes the name of any male person or animals. Feminine gender includes the name of any female person or animal. Neuter gender includes the name of things without life. That means lifeless things comes under this category. Then next, the name of any animal or person that may be either male or female is said to be in common gender. Common gender includes the name of things which can be either a male or a female. You will study in detail about these things in further slides. Our first gender is masculine gender. A noun that is the name of any male person or animal is said to be of the masculine gender. For example, boy, man, father, brother, horse, etc. Children, let me give you an example. Mohan is a handsome boy. So in this sentence, Mohan and boy are the name of males. So these are masculine gender. It comes in masculine gender. So the name of any male person or animal is said to be of the masculine gender. Let's move on to the next slide. Next one is feminine gender. A noun that is the name of any female person or animal is said to be of the feminine gender. For example, girl, woman, mother, sister, mare, etc. Let me take an example. Mohini is a pretty girl. So in this sentence, Mohini and girl are the name of females. So both the words comes in feminine gender. That is why we can say that the name of any female person or animal is said to be of the feminine gender. Let's move on to the next slide now. Next is neuter gender. A noun that is the name of a thing without life is said to be of the neuter gender. For example, pen, pencil, eraser, sharpener, book, copy, blackboard, chalk, etc. Let me take an example. She writes a letter with the pencil. In this sentence, letter and pencil are the name of the things without life. These are non-living things. So, in this case, these are of neuter gender. Let's move on to the next slide. Next is common gender. A noun that is the name of an animal or person that may be either male or female is said to be of the common gender. For example, parents. It can either be father or mother. Siblings. It can be either a brother or a sister. Let me take one more example. Students should respect their teachers. In this example, students and teachers are words that can be used for both males and females. Your students can also be a girl child or a boy child. And your teacher can also be a man or a woman. So in both the cases, we use teachers and students. They are common nouns. We can commonly use these words. So these comes in common gender. I repeat once again, a noun that is the name of an animal or person that may be either male or female is said to be of the common gender. Here are few points that you must always remember. Only living creatures can be male or female. For example, on the living ones we can call it male or female. We cannot call a mobile phone either a male or female, or a pen, whether it be male or female. So only living creatures can be male or female. Things without life cannot be male or female. As we have already discussed, that non-living things or things without life are not male or female. We use he for a singular male human. We use he. In the singular male human, we use he. Instead of names, we sometimes use he as a pronoun. Next, we use she for a singular female human. She is used as a pronoun in place of any noun when it is singular female human. We use it for a male or a female animal and things without life. That means for the non-living things and animals, we use it. We use they for the plural of male or female animals and things without life. They is used in the plural form of male or female animals and things without life. That means for lifeless things and for animals, in plural form we use they. Same in case of male and female humans also, means things with life or human beings also, we use they for the plural of male or female humans. Next is formation of feminine nouns. Some feminine nouns are formed by a change of words. Let's have a look. Masculine, boy will simply change to girl. Brother, sister. Bull, cow. Horse, mare. Husband, wife. King, queen. Lord, lady. Man, woman. Monk, nun. Uncle, aunt. Some feminine nouns are formed by adding e double s to the masculine. Let's have a look. Actor is changed to actress. Conductor, conductress. Hunter, huntress. Emperor, empress. Prince, princess. Tiger, tigress. Traitor, traitress. Waiter, waitress. Master, mistress. Lion, lioness. So here words have been changed to feminine gender by simply adding e double s. Some feminine nouns are formed by replacing a word before or after. Let's have a look at them. For example, grandfather changes to grandmother. Landlord changes to landlady. Milkman, milkwoman. Peacock, peahen. Manservant, maidservant. Billy goat, nanny goat. Boyfriend, girlfriend. Sometimes we use a common word for both the male and female animals. Here are some examples. It happens often when we use these common words instead of using the masculine word or the feminine word for the animals, male or female animals. It generally happens when we are reading a story, we don't have to read it in the masculine or feminine word, then we use the common word for these animals. Let's have a look. Cow. We don't use bull or cow. We use it as cow. So here are the common words. here are the masculine of these words and here are the feminine of these words. Fowl, it's cock for the masculine, hen for the feminine. Dog, masculine dog, feminine bitch. Duck, it's drake for the masculine and duck as a feminine. Fox, fox is a masculine word while vixen is a feminine word. Goose, gender is a masculine word, goose is a feminine word. Horse, stallion is a masculine word, mare is a feminine word. Peafowl is a common word for peacock as a masculine word and peahen is a feminine word. Pig, boar is the masculine word for pig and sow is the feminine word. Sheep, ram is the masculine of sheep and ewe is the feminine of sheep. Swan, cob is the masculine word for swan and pin is the feminine word for swan. We generally use the common words for rather than using this masculine or feminine words. In stories also we generally find these words. Let's move on to the next slide now. Sometimes we also use a common word for the male and female humans. Let's have a look at some examples. Sometimes what happens, we don't use a particular word for a group of people. Suppose we are in a class or we are let me take an example of a class. Suppose we are in a class, then we use the word students. Instead of calling a girl or a boy, we may use student. So it can either be a girl or boy. Here also some few examples are given. For example, the masculine word is boy and feminine word is girl. Instead of using a boy and girl, we use child. Men, women, we use person. Person can either be a male or female. Then father, mother, we call it parents. Siblings, it can either be a brother or a sister. Same way, spouse. Spouse also includes either it can be a husband or a wife. So here are the common words we generally use in our day-to-day lives to denote any person. Move on to the worksheet session. So here in this exercise, few pictures are given along with the names. We have to tell the gender of each of the following words. First picture is of chair. So children, think in your mind and then answer these questions. So chair is a known living thing. So which gender it be? It will be neuter gender. Computer, is it a living thing? No, it is also a non-living thing. So it will be a neuter gender. Ram is a masculine word for sheep. So it will be a masculine word. The next one is cow. It is a feminine. Supposed to solve all these questions. You have to tell about umbrella's gender, then cock, tigress, pencil, bicycle, peacock. Let's move on to our next worksheet. Complete the following phrases using opposite gender. Actor and actress, boy and girl, brother and sister, cock and hen, dog and bitch, drake and duck, emperor and empress, fox and vixen. These are few phrases that has been used in our day-to-day life. Thank you kids for watching the video. That's all for the day. Thank you children. Hope you all have enjoyed your class well. Stay healthy and be safe at home. Thank you.